Good evening and welcome to Fulfilling Your Destiny. I am your host, ML, and I am so excited about what we're going to learn on this evening. As you're coming in, I ask that you would dust your feet off at the door by liking the broadcast, sharing the broadcast, tagging and inviting others to be a part of such a powerful experience and time that we're going to have on tonight. So push the share button. Don't be shy. Push it more than once and begin to share this on all of your social media platforms. There are people throughout this entire nation, throughout this entire world that needs to hear how to fulfill their destiny. You may have to call someone and say, listen, we are on Anointed TV at facebook.com/anointedtelevision. And you can find us on our YouTube channel right now on Anointed TV. Text them. Text them the link. Text them and let them know to chime in, because tonight is their night that they're going to learn it more about their destiny and how to fulfill it. Family, I love you all greatly. I know we live in different cities, different states, different neighborhoods, and different environments, but some of y'all can go outside and begin to just holler. Hey, listen, we're on Anointed TV. So be country one time. Go outside and scream to your neighbor. And let them know that we are on Anointed TV. Family, we have a few announcements that are going to come up. And then after the announcements, we'll be ready. We'll be prepared to go higher and higher. I love you all greatly. I'll see you in a moment. But make sure to do what? To like this broadcast. Share this broadcast. Tag and invite others to be a part of this experience. I'll be back after these messages.
Are you tired of pulling your hair out? Being frustrated with figuring your bills? There's never an abundance. Never enough money? There is a way to your wealthy place. Start your own business now. There's one way to officially set up a business, and that's the right way. Call Dr. Clay at Inspired Vision Consulting at area code 972-589-8319. We can immediately go to work for you. We inspire your vision. All you have to do is have an idea or thought of what you are dreaming of doing. We can coach you from there. We remove all of the guesswork. Full branding, incorporation, websites, logos, marketing services, nonprofit and church startup, even 501c3 services, grant writing, and more is available to you. We have assisted thousands of businesses around the nation, and we are excited about serving you. It's time for you to live your dream. Stop just thinking about it. Let's do it. Payment plans are available. Yes, payment plans are available. Get your business started now. We have a New Year's special for only $299 to get you started. Yes, a New Year's special for $299. You've got this. Call Dr. Clay at Inspired Vision Consulting at 972-589-8319. Our website is www.inspiringyourvision.org. That's www.inspiringyourvision.org.
Good evening. We're back, and I'm so glad to be back. I'm so glad to have each and every one of you tuned in with me tonight for fulfilling your destiny. I hope and pray that you have come prepared with your minds ready to receive, to intake, and to digest this wealth of knowledge that I'm going to share with you. If this is your first time tuning in with me, will you just take this moment to type in the comment section that you're a first-time guest. This is your first time. I would love for our administrators and those who are tuned in with us to acknowledge you and to say welcome. And I hope and pray that something is said or done that will assist you in your journey called life. Before we go a step further, let us look to the Lord, most gracious and heavenly Father. Lord, we honor you, we praise you, we bless you, and we magnify your name. We thank you for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for what you're going to share with us on tonight. I ask that you speak to me and through me to your people, that they will receive what you have for them concerning their purpose in life. In Jesus' name, amen. If you all agree with me, will you just type it in the comment section, amen? Family, on last Friday, we began a discussion on discovering our destiny. And we came to understand that in order for us to be eligible in fulfilling our destiny, it must first be revealed. So tonight I want to open our conversation with a few questions. Those questions are, do you ever have questions about your purpose? Do you ever have questions about your purpose? Do you ever wonder what it is that you have to offer to this world? Have you ever considered why you even exist in the first place? If you've ever asked yourself this question, and there are many others, But if you've ever asked yourself this question or these questions, guess what? You are not alone. Most people are unknowing about their place, their position, and their purpose in life. Many of which conclude that life just doesn't make sense. But wait a minute. Before we make that our conclusion, shouldn't we, the children of God, have a clearer picture of our calling? Shouldn't we, the children of the Most High God, have a clear vision of where we fit in? After all, we have a personal connection with our Creator. The author and the finisher of our faith. We, the children of God, have a personal relationship with the architect, the begetter and composer of meaning and purpose of life. We, the children of God, have access. We have direct access to the inventor and the founder himself, the Lord God Almighty. Yes, it's 9 o'clock at night, y'all. I'm taking my time because I need everybody to get this. That since we are connected in a personal relationship with the Creator of the heavens and the earth, since we are in a personal relationship with the manufacturer of the universe, shouldn't our vision, our calling, our destiny be most clear for us, his children, than anyone else in the world? Discovering our God-given destiny is difficult, I must admit. But it's not impossible. Discovering our God-given destiny is strenuous. But it's not hopeless. Discovering our destiny takes hard work and labor.
It is a tedious exercise, but yet it is an exciting one. Yes. Discovering our destiny is so exciting. It's every morning when I rise, I rise with this passion, this drive, I rise with this certain level of commitment, no matter how strenuous my day before was, no matter the challenges that lie before me on today. Just the mere fact that I understand that and I comprehend that I'm walking in my destiny, it causes something on the inside of me to begin to stir. It causes something on the inside of me. It causes something on the inside to get up. No matter the battle, no matter the war, no matter what all took place the day before or what lies ahead, there's something in me that says, listen, we can't stay right here. We can't just lay right here. It's something inside of me that says, listen, great job, you accomplished that. But there is more to be accomplished. There's something that tells me, listen, we can't just stay here all day and night and all week, all month, all year celebrating this particular victory. But you have got to get up and strive for more. Discovering our destiny for many is a lifelong search. It is a lifelong search that many are seeking to locate. But there are few that find it. There are countless amounts of people desiring to know what they were created for. Why was I created? I mean, why me? Why was I created to be this height, this size, this weight, this color? There's countless amounts of people desiring to know what they were created for. Desiring to know why they were born. Desiring to know who they are. And there are so many individuals who haven't discovered it. And as a result, they drift through life feeling incomplete. They drift through life feeling fragmented and insignificant. There are so many people who have not discovered their destiny. Therefore, they drift through life feeling sketchy, superficial and vague, as though they are inadequate, unequal, and of non-importance, which is so far from the truth. Yet because of the disconnect get y'all to see this. Because of the disconnect between them and the knowing of their destiny, many are left wishing they were someone else. Many are left wishing that their upbringing was different. Yeah, I know I'm talking to you. Many are left wishing that their past was a blessed history. There are so many people who are left hoping that one day, can somebody say one day? There are so many people who are wishing that one day they will stumble into their purpose. By chance that one day they will stagger into their dreams, or by the way, just fall into their paradise. But I believe that through these teachings, your destiny will no longer be a mystery. I just believe that through these teachings, your destiny will no longer be unknown or a secret to you. But I believe that through these teachings, your destiny will be fulfilled. Your destiny will be revealed, and it will be fulfilled by you. Let me say it again. I believe that through these teachings, your destiny will be revealed and it will be fulfilled by you. If you believe it, just type in the comment section, "I believe it." While you're typing it, I want you to say it out of your mouth. "I believe it." If you're watching on YouTube, type it in the chat section. "I believe it." Let us look at Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. Even though this is not a church setting, but I must let it be known that the word of God is the center of everything that is good. So there is no way that I can teach you or help you to discover what your destiny is without the word of God. And that's where a lot of us are losing. I say us because I don't point fingers. That's why I'm not losing, y'all, but that's why a lot of people are losing, because they're trying to fulfill destiny outside of the will of God. They're trying to enjoy life outside of the will of God. They're trying to build. They're trying to invest. They're trying to grow and develop in whatever area or whatever ideal that they have. They're trying to do it outside of the will of God. And that's why it continues to crumble. That's why it continues to fall. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. And it reads, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them." Let me say it again. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them. This passage of scripture opens by stating that we are God's workmanship. What is workmanship? For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them. So what is workmanship? For my note takers, the word workmanship is defined as the art or skill of a workman. Workmanship. The art or skill of a workman. Workmanship is also defined as handiwork, design or expertise of a skilled manufacturer. And this skilled manufacturer, maker and master is the Lord God Almighty. I'm trying to show you your value. I'm trying to show you, God is trying to show us how priceless we are. We are created in Christ Jesus unto good works. In other words, you are designed for a purpose. You're not here for nothing. It is not a coincidence that you're here. It is not by chance that you've made it this far through life. You and I are here because God has a purpose for which he designed us and brought us into being. You are skillfully designed the way you are for a specific reason. Let me say it again. You are skillfully designed the way that you are designed for a specific reason. Many of you beat yourself up and beat yourself down because of your design. When truth be told, God designed you the way he designed you for a specific reason. I need you to get this. Many of you allow yourself and others to demean you, to belittle you, to walk on you like a doormat, not understanding that God skillfully designed you that the way that he has for a specific reason. And God wants you to know, and he wants you to notice how valuable, how treasured, and how worthwhile you really are to him. Yeah. ML, I thought you said this was about fulfilling your destiny. It is. God wants you to recognize that you are beautifully and wonderfully made. Too many of God's children are tucked somewhere in the corner with their heads down and their eyes closed and their face in their hand, afraid, amen, to look up, afraid to shine because of abuse and being beat down and dogged out. And so now that you don't feel like you're valuable, now you feel like there's no real meaning for your existence. And that is far from the truth. Everything that God has created was good. Remember in Genesis when he created the light? And what did he say? It was good. Then he created the lesser light, which was the moon. And he said what? It was good. He created the grass, the trees. Come on, y'all. The flowers, the birds, all living animals. And what did he say? What did he say? It was good. Then he created man and woman in his own likeness and image. I need y'all to get it. And then he gave them a commandment. He said, he blessed them first, and then he told them to be fruitful and to multiply. God created us for a specific purpose and reason. And not only that, the key to this thing is he created us in his likeness and in his image. What a mighty God we serve. He's a great God. And he created us in his likeness and in his image. What are you saying? I'm saying that you are valuable, you are treasured, and you are worthwhile. God created you. He created me. He created us with great details, great design, with a great plan for you and I in his mind. The gifts that you have were bestowed upon you. They were given and entrusted to you. What he gave you, no one else has. It may be similar, but what he gave you, it's special. It's a song says, what God has for me, it is for me. And then the song continues on to go on and it says, what God has for you, it is for you. There are some specific things that God placed in you that he desires to come forth out of you to produce a harvest in the world around you. So these gifts that he has bestowed upon you, that he has given and entrusted to you, so that you will have the capability, the capacity and the quality to achieve certain accomplishments that God had in his mind when he fashioned you in your mother's womb. Yeah. Let me back up. Let me show you this. Ephesians 2 and 10, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained. This was ordained before we got here. This was ordained before you were born. Can I share something else with you? God already knew that in 2022 we would be dealing with a pandemic. He already knew about the coronavirus and all of its variants. He already knew about the economy. Can I go a little bit deeper? He already knew about the drug addiction, the alcoholism. Come on, y'all. He already knew about the gambling problems or whatever other problems, the sickness and disease. He already knew what we were going to deal with, what we were going to encounter in our life right now, because he is all-knowing, the only wise God, our Savior. But the Bible says he created us, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should do what? Walk. Let me get my walk together. He had before ordained that we should walk. That we should walk in them. So what is he? So what are we seeing here? What are we hearing here? We are hearing that our destiny is already in place. Our purpose is already in place. It has already been ordained. Now it is our responsibility to discover it and to walk in it. Are y'all with me tonight? If you're with me, just type in the comment section. I'm with you. The enemy, okay? The enemy. I gotta say this. The white man is not your enemy. The politicians, the government, that's not our enemy. The devil is our enemy that work behind and through people, places, and things, okay? We must recognize who our enemy is. His name is Satan, Lucifer, the accuser of the brethren, the devil, a liar, a murderer since the beginning. The devil does not want you to know that you are valuable. I'm going to let that sizzle in your spirit for a second. The devil does not want you to know that you are valuable. The devil does not want you to know that you are valuable. And he does not want you to know that greatness has been planted on the inside of you. He don't want you to know that. The devil don't want you to know greatness in you. I don't know why I keep referring to Genesis, but when God created man, from the dust of the ground, from the dust of the earth. Can I share something with you? He formed man from red clay dirt. Okay. It's just a little nugget. God formed man from red clay dirt. And that's why the first man's name was Adam. Because Adam means red clay dirt. Okay. God created man from this from the dust of the ground, this red clay dirt, and then he blessed him with a gift. He breathed the breath of life into this red clay dirt. He planted greatness, oh my God, inside of this dirt suit. And the enemy does not want you to know that greatness is on the inside of you, because this greatness that is on the inside of you, it is made in the image and the likeness of God. The enemy does not want you to know that you are cherished, and that you are God's prized possession. The enemy does not want you to know that. That you are a trophy to God. And as long as you don't know who you are and whose you are, it is quite difficult, troublesome, and problematic in fulfilling your destiny. As long as you are unaware, uninformed, or in the dark concerning the gift that God has gifted you with, oh my God, then your destiny being your purpose, excuse me, is unattainable, it is elusive, and unreachable. The devil does not want you to recognize, number one, that you are somebody special, and that God created you with great things on his mind concerning you in your life. And the enemy don't want you to understand that there are some things in you that is a blessing to you, a blessing to your family, and everybody connected to you. So as long as we are unaware of those things, as long as we are in the dark, feeling like, you know, because where we grew up or who our parents were or how we were raised or the mistakes we made, as long as we are in the dark concerning the gifts in us and we're looking at all of these other things, we'll go through life struggling, go through life angry, go through life frustrated, on the verge of suicide, depressed, because we don't recognize that God has a perfect plan and a destiny for our lives that he already preordained for us to walk in. And I truly believe that by you tuning in with me, every Friday evening at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time here on Anointed TV, I believe that your destiny will be discovered. It will be exposed, and your destiny will be identified. If you walk faithfully with me, I believe that your destiny will be brought to light. You know, like the lights in this studio, these bright lights. I believe that your destiny will be brought to life. I believe it will be brought forward and it will be brought into view, so that you can carry out your earthly assignment to the fullest degree. I have a question for you. How many of you want to fulfill your destiny? Talk to me tonight, y'all. You didn't stay up for nothing. How many of you desire to fulfill your destiny? I'm waiting on you. Talk to me. I need to know. Talk to me. How many of you not just wishing or hoping, but you really want to fulfill your destiny. Family, I believe by me assisting you in comprehending and perceiving the meaning of your unique greatness, this newfound understanding or this clear vision will relieve the guilt, because many of you all feel guilty right now. You don't have to tell me, I feel you. Many of you feel guilty right now because you're looking at your life and you're saying, listen, I'm this age and I'm this age. I'm this person. I'm that person. I'm a mom. I'm a dad. I'm this, that, and the other, but I do not know what my destiny is. And so you're feeling a sense of guilt, a sense of shame, condemning yourself, telling yourself you're nothing and nobody, and whatever you have going on, this is the best it's going to be. You know, there's no need in expecting anything else. You know, I was born in the projects and I'm going to die in the projects. No, 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 no. You don't have to remain where you are. That's the wonderful thing about God. The beauty of it is when we pray, he hear us. Did you all know that? That when you pray, he hear you? And so because of your prayers, Anointed TV was birthed. Because of your prayers on Friday nights at 9 o'clock Central Standard Time, here I am trying to teach and show you how to fulfill your destiny. And in learning how to fulfill your destiny, guess what's going to happen? You're going to get your joy back, your strength back. Come on, y'all. Your happiness back. You're going to start back exercising and eating properly. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Why? Because you are discovering your destiny. And this newfound understanding, not only will it relieve the guilt, catch this, but it will relieve the guesswork in you trying to determine and or discover God's will for your life. It's going to help with all the guesswork, y'all. Some of us 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years old, still guessing, still trying to figure it out. Who am I? What am I supposed to do? We get married, we have children, and so we're focused on raising our children and getting them off to college, and then what then after that? What do we do after the children are gone? Once they're living their lives, and that we're empty nesters, as I have not experienced yet, but what happens after that? What happens after we get our degree? What happens after we get the job that we've been seeking? What happens after we've saved the amount of money that we wanted to save? What happens next? And so many of us are guessing, trying to figure this thing out, and we're bumping our toes, we're getting bumps and bruises, scrapes and scars, trying to figure this thing out. And sometimes, due to the guesswork, some of us say, "You know what? I quit. I'm tired of trying to figure this out. It's too hard. It hurts too bad. I've invested too much." But I believe that through this teaching every Friday night, that the guesswork and the guilt is going to be relieved off of you as God reveals his destiny to you. I understand that every day we are bombarded with expectations from our friends, bombarded with expectations from our parents, classmates, professors, church, and society as a whole. Every day, we are attacked or battered by opinions, attitudes, mindsets and ideas every day. And within all the madness, within all the mayhem and the misfortunes, we are still inclined. We are still assigned. We are still inspired to fulfill our destiny. That's what I was saying a moment ago at the beginning of this, that no matter all the madness, no matter all the mayhem, no matter all of the misfortune and the misery that I encounter in life, I'm still inclined to fulfill my destiny. No matter what goes on in life, we still have an assignment. A God-ordained assignment to fulfill our destiny. No matter the sickness and pain, the sunshine or the rain, we must still be inspired to fulfill our destiny. And I'm going to bring you the inspiration. Yeah. I'm going to bring you the encouragement. I'm going to bring you what you need. I'm going to bring the gasoline. That's it. I'm going to bring the gasoline to pour on your fire so that your passion will burn even stronger. We are full of an array of gifts, talents, visions and dreams. And they all include a blueprint of God's intention for how He wants us to invest these various things in and through our lives. We're full of beautiful things, full. And God has given us the blueprint. He has given us the blueprint on how He wants us to invest these gifts and talents, on how to invest our lives. So with the help of God, I'm going to do my very best in helping you to not only to discover your destiny, but I'm going to help you to fulfill your destiny. Why? Because I love you. Why? Because God loves you. Why? Because He has a purpose and a plan for your life. And the things that He has placed in you, the world needs it. Your family needs it. You need it. Your gifts will make room for you. Yes. And put you before great men. I'm believing that every person that's watching now and going to watch in the future, I'm believing that your God-given destiny is going to be fulfilled by you, because no one else can do it. I can't do it. Your twin can't do it. Your brother, your sister, your mother, your daddy can't do it. Your children can't do it. This assignment, this journey, has been made specifically for you. He has placed some things in you that only you can produce. See, every apple seed, when planted, can only produce apples. Every orange seed, when planted, can only produce oranges. Only sycamore trees can produce sycamore trees. Only pine trees can produce pine trees. Are y'all hearing what I'm trying to tell you? There is something that he has planted in you. A seed of greatness that has to be planted by you so that the harvest can come forth. I understand that one apple seed, when it is planted, it can produce a whole apple orchard. It can produce trees. It can produce apple trees. That's called exceeding abundantly. That's called exceeding abundantly above all that we can ever ask or think. One apple seed planted, that's one of those pressed down, shake it together and run it over type of blessings. But if the enemy can keep you or position you in a way that you don't plant the seed, then the harvest that God intended for you, the blessings that God intended for you, the great things that God has intended for you and your children's children, even to the fourth generation, it will never come forth. And that's why we have a world of family members who are carrying generational curses. It's too many of us who are living out generational curses. But I come to break that curse tonight. In the name of Jesus. And I speak generational blessings. Come on, somebody. Over your life. I need you to type that in the comment section. Generational blessings. Come on. I need you to type it. And while you're typing it, I need you to speak it out of your mouth. Speak it out of your mouth that I'm walking in generational blessings. I'm walking in generational wealth. Come on. I need for you to touch and agree with me from wherever you are. Yes, this is Anointed TV. We're not going to turn this into a church service, but it is what it is. I understand the power and the authority that God has given unto me. And I don't mind breaking the devil's jaw. I don't mind rebuking the witch and the warlock. I don't mind rebuking the generational curse that has caused itself to creep into our homes across this world. But tonight we declare generational blessings, generational wealth. In the name of Jesus. Destiny fulfillers. That's who you are. You are a destiny fulfiller. I declare that you are a destiny fulfiller. I need you to touch and agree with me tonight. I need you to prophesy over your own self. and say, I am a destiny fulfiller. Come on, open your mouth. Open your mouth. I am a destiny fulfiller. I am a destiny fulfiller. I hope and pray something was said on tonight that has blessed you, that has encouraged you, that has stirred up the gifts on the inside of you to cause you to dream again, to cause you to believe again, to cause you to get up to fight again, to cause you to seek and to find all that God has for you. The Bible says, ask and ye shall receive. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. I truly believe that each and every person under the sound of my voice now and in the future are asking God for his help, are asking God for the way in which we should go. I believe that you are seeking to discover, to reveal, to uncover what your destiny, what your purpose is in life. I believe that you're not just seeking in your seats, but you have gotten up and you're going to the door of opportunity. And you're knocking, and the door is going to be open unto you in the name of Jesus. I just need you to type in the comment section, I'm knocking. Come on, just type it in the comment section. I'm knocking. I'm knocking. I'm knocking. And as you're knocking on that door, before I close out tonight, I'm going to ask you all, if you would, to consider sowing into our broadcast ministry. There are so many things that we are desiring to do in the various communities, and we're only able to do it through your help. Soon you're going to see announcements coming up here in the near future concerning some things that we are endeavoring to do. We are partnering with Family Vibes Incorporated, as well as with Anointed Praise and Worship Ministries, with their Helping Hands initiative. And we're desiring to do some great things for the poor, though, and some great things for the less fortunate. And I truly believe that because of your seed sown, we're going to be able to make great impact, that we're going to be able to change lives. You see the information on the screen to sow via Cash App at $ Anointed TV. Sow a seed tonight to assist us. Sow a seed in helping us make a difference in some child's life, in some family member's house, in some single parent's home. Help us to make a difference. And we'll truly be grateful. And I know that God will bless you for what you do. As I prepare to leave this place, whenever his presence, we're going to pray. Y'all, I must pray God's blessing over us. That seals it. That's the benediction. It seals what we have received so that the enemy cannot come and steal our seeds. The enemy can't come and steal what has been imparted into our hearts on tonight. He can't come and steal the promises that has been revealed, that we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works. Can you hear what I'm telling you? We have been ordained to walk in the blessings of God. And I pray even now Father God, I thank you for your people tonight. I thank you for their investments of their time on tonight. They could have been anywhere else doing anything else, but their desire was to be here with us on tonight, on this broadcast, fulfilling your destiny. Father, I pray right now that the spiritual seeds that have been sown into your people will take deep root and produce much fruit. Also pray that even after the broadcast is over, that your ministering angels will continue to speak to their hearts and minds and stir up their gifts and cause them to seek you while you may be found, to call on you while you are near. Also pray, God, that you will bless every financial seed sower on tonight that have taken the time to sow into this vision. God, bless them 100-fold for whatever they do. In Jesus' name, amen. Family, I love you all. Y'all, do you love me? Do you love me? I love you all greatly. I will see you all next Friday night, 9 p.m. right here on Anointed TV on Fulfilling Your Destiny. Please invite somebody else to be a part. Please invite somebody else, amen, to be blessed by what God is doing here. And if you haven't already liked our Facebook page, please do so. We're constantly uploading new content every day and words of encouragement and words of inspiration. And we want you to be a part of that encouragement. We want you to be a part of that inspiration. So please follow us here on Facebook.com/Anointed Television. And if you have not connected with us on our YouTube channel, it's a very new thing, y'all. So we ask that you all would just take out the time to go to our YouTube channel at Anointed TV, that you will subscribe and turn on your notifications. We appreciate you. We love you, and God bless you. Till next time.